questions and comments, please raise your hands so that we can do it efficiently. Okay, Jayavardhan, Agni, anybody else? Okay, so we'll start there. Can we pass the mic on?
Good afternoon, sir. This is Jayavardhan from third year. This is Jayavardhan from third year. So before I ask my question, I just want to tell you this, that I'm really thankful for your contribution to legal scholarship, and it's very enriching. It's very enlightening to read your essays. So my question is with regard to what you said in the context of international law. You said that the third world, it's not accurate to define the third world in the context of geographical limitations, but you need to realize that every country has its own third world, and there is a growing emphasis on recognizing that individuals should be the subject of international law, and that way we'll be able to address their concerns in a much better manner. But then, sir, we can also not neglect the fact that sovereignty is a great virtue, and you know, it set loggerheads with recognizing the fact that we need to help the third world. And if it is true, the premise of one of the major premises of international law, that we should establish some kind of parity in the interaction between the weaker parties and the, you know, stronger parties, how do you address this slightly problematic situation? As in, how do you balance sovereignty with, you know, recognizing and helping the third world in all these countries?
Thank you. I'll take another one.
Agni, you can ask your question.
Sir, I am basically a student of history, and I am associated with other social sciences.
I can't hear.
Yeah, yeah.
My ear has gone on left ear.
Ah, sir.
Is on permanent sabbatical.
Sir, do you hear me now? Okay, sir.
Yeah.
Sir, I am a student of history and other social sciences, and as a layman in the context of discussing anything regarding constitution, my familiarity begins with the amendment history of constitution, because they are socially contextualized. And the amendments, when you said in favor of the fragments, before we discuss any identity, amendments are a manner of taking care of the fragments of the identities that are actually left in the identity formations, or as you said, identification as a process. When fragments are left away, including them in by way of amendment, will make the constitution a hypertext also, besides making it a hypertext and actually a text. Then how do we actually understand the institutional visualization of a constitution in terms of taking care of a fragment, and the amendment making fragment a matter of central focus and connecting it to the constitutional care of institutional process? That is actually whether amendment is a subtext, our constitution itself is having a suggestion for the subtext through its institutional visualization, is my question. Yes.
I think as you like.
Are there some more comments or questions right now?
Take three at a time. And then
okay, so we'll take one more, and then Professor Bakshi will answer. So I saw a couple of hands here. Okay, Sabra and Satendra after that. So we'll take one more, and then we'll ask Professor Bakshi to respond.
Hi, sir. Sir, my question is, so if there's a differentiation between the reality and what is normative, how do we draw, and if the constitution is made for the people, how do we draw that line between deciding whether we should stop interpreting the constitution and change it entirely? And secondly, if the value of a constitution comes from the interpretation of it and from the interpretation that we give it, then do you believe that there is such a thing as a wrong interpretation of the constitution? Thank you.
Yeah, I can't respond in detail to all the very good comments, and there are more to come. I'm very grateful for your interjection. Starting taking the last comment first, because fresh, just now spoken, I think. Some people say that constitution is meant for the people, a popular sovereignty. And some people say it is a charter of governance, power of governance. And people are served by governance, obviously, and developed. So what the Indian constitution did was novel at its time. It wrestled with four ideas. The constitution is about governance, it is about development, it is about rights, and it is about justice. The constitution, the four ideas conflict. Governance conflicts with development, development conflicts with justice, rights conflict with them all. They are conflicted ideas, or what the sociologists call nested concepts. So when you say constitution is meant, if that was what you said, I thought I read you were saying that, the constitution is meant for people, it is meant for people by several mediations, executive mediation, legislative mediation. If you study the Forest Act, if you study the Darega, Barega, etc., if you study the legislation, it is no doubt serving in some way the people. But people themselves are being mediated. That is one aspect. The second aspect is changes in the constitution and changes of the constitution. If we make this distinction, then the Supreme Court says you can't enact a change of the constitution unless I agree. There is no change of the constitution. The Indian constitution therefore acquires the identity. This is the Indian constitution. Nani Palkabaratu. India is the only country when such a man will be called a jurist. Because in a book called We the People of India is a chapter in which he says it was a mistake to give adult franchise. Well, it's written there. His book is titled We the People. And he says it was a mistake to give vote to women, or mistake to give vote to non-matriculate. That apart. But Nani Palkar was a good lawyer, because he argued in Keshwaranda, and nobody has said Article 368 the way he did. He simply said to the judges, the lordship, the Article 368 contemplates changes in the constitution, but does not contemplate change of the constitution. My objection, it's not his. He argued before the lordship. He said, at the end of all the amendments, what Article 360 says, the constitution shall stand amended. And he only took recourse to the repeated article, the. What shall survive the amendments? My lord, that was the art. What is the constitution? That's the art of a lawyer. So he said, and the court said, what the constitution? Well, you can't amend as you please. There are certain basic features, essential features, etc. I don't know whether I answered you or question, but roughly what I heard and what I said may correspond, but we can discuss it further. On the question of identity, sociology and difference, lots have been written on the... Sorry, can you hear me? Lots have been written on the question of identity. There are several types of practices of identification. For example, Rohit formulas of the world. if I may mention the other university here, there is something called, they are labeled with a primary identity of being backward or untouchable. Certain sections of people are called by the constitution the directive principles as weaker sections of society. They are weaker in 1950, they are weaker now. So I suggested an amendment. I told you the other day. I told the other class. I suggested an amendment. Nobody listens to me. That's the enjoyment of scholarship. Nobody listens. But I said, I proposed an amendment which said you should say progressively weakened sections of society. It can't be weaker. I can't be weak in 50 and 60 and 70 and 80 and 90. I can't be weaker. I've been progressively weakened. So one is primordial identity whose job is to progressively weaken the sections you identify. So primordial identity is a label. Once you are born into untouchables, you are always untouchable. That's primordial. A woman, all that baggage carries, misogynist prejudice. So that's one. Then there is sociologists distinguish between, as you know, between ascribed status and achieved status. Ascribed is ascribed by others, achieved by yourself. So you can borrow identity, you can shop around identity. There is no mall, no? Is there a mall in India which sells identities? You can buy, I want to buy this identity, that. There must be a mall, I would say. I should sell the idea to someone, Amazon or Flipkart or Bharti, Walmart, somewhere. There must be a special corner where you can buy identity. Like in America, in New York, I went the first time, they had got a perfume which was called Charisma. So, Porsche Weber, Max Weber invented the concept of Charisma. Here you just spray on and you are charismatic. You don't have to do the hard work of being charismatic, okay? And so, they ascribe primordial, ascribe achieved identity. And there is the identity, identity in practice, which is I've identified the future of human rights book. I say, is there a human right to change identities? All human rights instruments are silent, but I believe there is. Is there a human right to manage identity conflicts? No instrument in human rights goes that far. But I think Shabano is the case in point of changing identities, managing conflicts. She said to me in the tape of hers, Sima Sakhare went to from Nagpur to see her, and she was in the control of the in-laws. So daughter-in-law would not allow access. Sima Sakhare said, I'm a doctor. She thought the medical doctor. It's a doctorate in PhD in sociology. So she went to the false pretenses, and the interview was taped and sent to me. Sima is one of my textual children after open letter, and she's a giant in Nagpur on women's rights, very firm, very indigenous. And Sima was told by Savanu, and I quote, these words are written here, Ye mazhab kya cheej hai? What is this thing called religion? I want my mazhab, but don't get me wrong. I'm a woman, but I insist on being a Pak aurat. You know, 65 or something. I've got not on the tape now. But the right to manage the identity of being a Pak aurat, she was not going the secular path, kafir path. He was going her path. Identity, she had to manage the conflict of identity. One side is asking for, she's reforming Islamic law of maintenance. On the other side, but she's not secular. the reform within Sharia. The right to manage conflict of identity is very important. It's a very large theme. I can't possibly go into this, but this classification of various type practices of identification is, I think, very useful way of proceeding, one useful. And when you talk of identity, I must say immediately, you are simultaneously talking of difference. In fact, all identity talk is about difference. I am different from you, therefore I have this identity. So identity, what is the identity of the Constitution is a question, or we can rephrase the question, whatever be the identity of the Constitution, does it make a difference? We socialist today, secular tomorrow, democratic day after, whatever. Does it make a difference in real life? I want to live a life. Does it make a difference? You can ask this at Professor Formula, I can ask this. You can ask this a professor in Nalta, you can ask the student, you can ask this question. Law, it depends on who you are, why you are asking it. But ask this question, you must. So that's the practice of identification. Now finally, the first question was about international law and how the, it's a very important point. Well, you're quite right, I say after Trump and Brexit, and the impending elections in France and Germany, I'm tired of saying this, but I must say it once more, that the whole world is a third world. Now, I must hold the hands of our American sisters, who are now going to be denied their right to reproductive autonomy very shortly by the Congress and the President. So we, the so-called third world, is paradoxically an heir to critical enlightenment. And the so-called first world, which said, we gave you enlightenment, we civilized you, we gave you language, we gave you science, we gave you progress, we gave you development, although we're enslaved, doesn't matter, is now in need of help. So if every world, the whole world is becoming third world, then obviously there is no third world beyond the world. And we have a duty to help each other. But that was not your question. Your question was more about third world international law. And I simply say to you this much. I draw attention to my paper on boundaries and borders of international law, which was published last year in the Indiana Journal of Global Studies, where I essentially say, the third world may have gone, but third worldism remains. The spirit of the third world, the spirit of justice, the spirit of reconciliation, the spirit of non-alignment, and so on and so forth. So, of course you're right, there is domestic jurisdiction and there is international domestic sovereignty and international law, and both have to coexist. And ever since the League of Nations, the attempt has been in that direction of international law. The Charter also to Article 27. So there are conflicts, but they are handled both by the states and by the UN in ways which you may not approve, but they are handled from time to time. But there's a very good question.
Right. So actually, since we have regular classes soon, we'll have to wrap up quickly now. So if you have direct questions, you can always ask Professor Bakshi just before the class in the evening. So before we conclude, for the students, the article where Professor Bakshi has clearly outlined his C3 framework of text interpretation ideology is called Constitutions as a Site of State Formative Practices. So that's an article that appears in Cardozo Law Review more than a decade ago, but obviously, as he mentioned in his talk, he's developed that idea much further. So having said that, right, we hope that we will at least try and show some implementation of your ideas with the kind of research that we are trying to do. And certainly with the curriculum changes that we've brought in the recent past, we are trying to open up more pathways for knowledge from other disciplines to seep in, and to obviously also see law as fundamental to the humanities and social sciences inquiry. So thank you again for your time, and for the students also, I hope that there's a lot to take away, just in terms of how you would approach your doctoral subjects from now on. Right.